Well, good afternoon. I'm Westchester County Executive George Latimer, and we're very honored to have with us New York State Comptroller Thomas DiNapoli, and also joined by New York State Assemblyman David Buchwald, and in a few minutes, New York State Senator Shelley Mayer. We're here today because the Comptroller has been doing a brilliant job in getting people free money. And if you don't like free money, then there's something wrong with you. In this particular case, the unclaimed funds program under the management of Comptroller DiNapoli for the last 10 years has returned a tremendous amount of money to New York State residents all across our area. And here in Westchester County, the county government itself did a search, since we do have a budget issue. We're trying to close a $30 to $50 million gap, and we found money in the Comptroller's unclaimed funds outlet. So we're happy that we were successful. We understand there's $272 million in the fund that tracks to Westchester businesses or individuals, but we're just very happy that the Comptroller is here to tell us about the program again and for his leadership in making sure that money's been available for all of us. So I'm very proud to be a longtime friend and strong supporter of our State Comptroller, Tom DiNapoli. Mr. Comptroller.
Thank you, County Executive Latimer, who's doing a great job at managing the county's finances. Yes. And no surprise, given his history of being involved at the city level, at the county level, that's when we first met, right? When you were on the county legislature, then the state assembly and the state senate. No, it's not that he can't keep a job, it's that he keeps moving up and up and up with more responsibility. And I really am delighted that he invited me to come by to talk about our unclaimed funds program, and certainly a thrill that we're joined by two great colleagues that we work with in state government doing an outstanding job as well. Our state senator, I got to get used to that title for you. We got to know each other many years ago, and then was thrilled when Shelley Mayer became a member of the Assembly, and certainly as a state senator as well. Give Senator Shelley Mayer a round of applause for being here. And I came from the state assembly, so I have a special place in my heart for anybody who not only has been there, but stays there too. So Assemblyman David Buchwald, thank you very much for everything you do, working hard for this community. And I must say, it is wonderful. I've never been inside the White Plains Beautiful. Library, but isn't this a magnificent library? I hope you realize that not every community has a library like this, and the staff greeted me so nicely, and it really is a pleasure to be here. County Executive Latimer, thank you for that generous introduction, and most importantly, for encouraging me to come here with my team. We're really here, and we're doing this announcement to give people information about the program, perhaps for people who aren't able to come down today. But we do have our team. They're going to be here till 4 o'clock, providing the opportunity for searches right online, right here at the library, to help people work through the process. And it's a relatively simple process. So people ask me many times, you know, we do many different things in the Comptroller's office. What is the most fun part of my job? Some things aren't fun, but I love doing all of it. But the most fun part is returning people's lost money. County Executive referred to it as free money, which is true. There's no charge or fee for claiming this money. And that's a very important point, because sometimes you will get a phone call or a letter from what is really a business, and sometimes people think it's from our office, saying you have unclaimed funds, we will get that money for you for a fee, and they could charge actually up to 15%. And the reality is, while it's legal, if you ever get a call or a letter like that, you should come right to the Comptroller's office, because in fact, there is no charge, there is no fee to process your application to get this money returned to you. It is your money. It's not a gift from New York. It is our opportunity to return money that we have held in safekeeping that has ended up in our unclaimed fund account. And we really have stepped up our effort, and we appreciate opportunities like this to be with elected colleagues. We do this work with community groups, senior centers, and so on. We really want to get the word out about this program. Unclaimed funds, very simply, is money that's been turned over to our office until we find the rightful owners or they find us. Sometimes called abandoned property, right? So it's not like putting the old furniture at the side of the road. This is different. Under state law, there are various ways in which financial accounts are declared dormant after a period of time. It's determined to be abandoned property. It's turned over to the Comptroller's Office. This happens in all the states of the nation. In New York, it's the Comptroller's Office that maintains it. Other states, they have a state treasurer office that may maintain it. And we keep those accounts, again, until we connect those accounts with the rightful owner. We have accounts now numbering 471,000 right here in Westchester County. And that means when you aggregate the dollar amount of those accounts, $272 million. You'd like that for the budget, right? That you're not going to get because it belongs to the residents of Westchester County. So we have a quick visual there that just summarizes, you know, for this county, how many accounts there are and how much money we are talking about. In fact, right here for the city of White Plains, $27 million. Accounts with White Plains addresses, $27 million right here for White Plains. In most cases, unclaimed funds come from all bank accounts. We also receive money from insurance companies, uncashed checks, utility deposits, stock accounts. There are many ways that people can be separated from their money. Most of the money comes to us from bank accounts, and it's typically accounts where there hasn't been activity. I had the personal experience, I will admit it, where I had moved and I had a little savings account was when I had my very first job as a teenager. So I had this little account and it wasn't my main account and it was in a bank. The bank changed names 5 times, but I still wanted to keep this account because it was what I opened in 1969. I had a sentimental attachment to it. But I had moved and I hadn't done anything, either in terms of withdrawal or deposit, for a period of time. And so I actually got a phone call from the bank, and they said, you know, we're looking for Tom DiNapoli. We have this account that hasn't been active. We're going to turn it over to the state comptroller's office. I said, wait a minute. That would look really bad if my own account gets turned over to the office. But you see, I moved in the same vicinity. I was still in Great Neck where I live. My phone number hadn't changed, even though my address hadn't changed. So they probably had tried to reach me at the old address. For whatever reason, it wasn't forwarded. So thankfully, they at least had my phone number. But the lesson is a simple one. If you have any kind of a bank account or financial account, make sure you periodically have some kind of activity. If you don't, it's declared dormant, and that's when the state gets the money. The other message is the other clear point is this: if you do move, update your contact information. That's the other challenge. Sometimes people move, they don't keep track of everything, and again, if there's no activity, that's how the money gets turned over. It is not unusual for there to be an insurance check, a health insurance check that for whatever reason was never cashed. Maybe you never received it. Sometimes people have a life insurance where they were the beneficiary. And again, for whatever reason, the life insurance company wasn't able to find you, so you never knew, you knew that Uncle George left you money that you didn't get. So there really are so many different ways that we can have money get separated from us and then it ends up in our office. As I said earlier, if you're contacted by a business saying they'll get this money recovered for you for a fee or for a charge, come right to us. Don't have any of this money go to anybody else. We've stepped up our outreach efforts, as the county executive said. We're now returning $1.5 million, roughly, a day to New Yorkers. That's a lot of money that we are sending out. Last year, for the year, we returned a total of $460 million across New York State. It's still a tough economy for many in our state. So whatever money you could get back through this program, that's found money. It helps you pay a bill. Maybe let you do something special for yourself that you weren't able to do otherwise. Most of the recoveries are $50 to $100 every now and then. It's not unusual to have many hundreds, many thousands. Our largest recovery was about $5 million that somebody had. It wasn't Mayor or Buckwald or Latimer. It was a stock account. Now, I'm not sure how you lose track of $5 million in a stock account, but whatever, somebody did. It's rare for it to be in the millions. It's not so rare for it to be in the thousands, though. Somebody came up to me at a community event recently and said, "Oh, I love your unclaimed funds program." I said, "Oh, good." I put in a claim. I said, "Oh, well, we'll help you." No, I said, "I already got the money." It was like $40,000 that this person had. So that's why we tell people, you know, search. And I appreciated the county exec reaching out to us, both because he wants the money that we owe the county, but also because he said, Tom, you know, I know this from my days in the legislature. This is an important service, and it's another opportunity for me to bring you and your team into Westchester County to make it easy for people, if they have the time today, to come by and search. But we do make it easy for you to search online. Back when I started as controller, there was no opportunity to search and then apply for the money online. We've changed that, and now I think it's close to 90% of the recoveries now actually happen online, not so much at events like this or the old-fashioned way of calling our 800 number or doing it by mail. That being said, we still have a call center because some folks prefer to talk to somebody. So I would just point out that during regular business hours, Monday through Friday, you can call 1-800-221-9311. That's one way to reach us. Also, the easiest way, as I said, is going online. So whatever your search engine is, put in New York State Controller. When you get to our website, click on the unclaimed funds section. For those of you who want the exact address, it's www.osc.state.ny.us. But just remember, New York State Controller, and put it into the search engine. And then you can search online. It's very, very easy. The system prompts you. And if it's an easy recovery, in a matter of days, you'll get a check. Now, I need to point out, people will right away put their own name in, and that's great. But you could put in, if you're a business owner, your business, if you're active with a nonprofit, a church, a synagogue, a mosque, a union, whatever it may be, unclaimed funds could be in the name of any organization that you're attached to. Government as well has unclaimed funds. Usually it's vendor checks, often insurance checks that warrant cash, seems to be the typical recovery for the government level. We also encourage people, obviously, put in names of family members and friends. You become very popular, you know, when you say, oh, you know, I found money for you on the controller's website. But also put in the names of deceased relatives. Sure. You may have parents, grandparents. The important thing to point out about these accounts is that they go back to the 1940s. And the accounts are maintained in perpetuity. People often ask me, does this money expire? No, it doesn't expire. The accounts remain active until we find you or you find us. We have over $15 billion, billion with a B, is the value of all the accounts we have now. Now, people sometimes ask me, Tom, you do this program and you keep returning all this money, and yet it seems that the amount of money that you have seems to grow. Well, that's actually true, because there were changes in law, so the dormancy period has been shortened in many cases, and there are new kinds of opportunities for unclaimed funds. Gift cards. You're right. Many people buy gift cards, you know, as a remembrance rather than an actual gift. And we always tell people, register the gift card. If it's just a cash, you know, like you go to a restaurant cash, we're never going to be able to find that if you didn't use it. But if you go through, you know, one of the bigger establishments, register the card. And as long as there's a registration, even if after a period of time it never was used or you lost it and the money gets turned over to us, if you have that registration number, we could track that back. So as much money as we're putting out through programs like this, money keeps coming into us. And you know, I mentioned if it's someone who deceased in your family, we might need, and we do need, more documentation, right? We have to establish that you are the rightful heir to the money. But sometimes people don't realize that a parent or a grandparent have passed away. Their accounts are also there for people to claim, and we encourage that as well. So I really want to thank the county exec for everything he does, and certainly for enabling us to provide this service today and to get the word out there. For those Westchester residents that can't come down today, hopefully you'll hear about it through our friends in the media, and I think the library is Facebooking us. So, this helps to get the word out. We really do appreciate that. I want to give the opportunity for our wonderful state legislators who honor us and do such great work. So I'm going to do that first, and then I'll do a presentation of the county executive. How does that sound? So protocol being what it is, no offense to the great assemblyman, she's got a big title now. She represents more constituents, you know.
Very brief. Thank you.
Shelley Mayer, our great state senator, thank you for being with us. Please say a few words.
Thank you. Just thank you for being here, getting the word out. I just wanted to make the point that you made at the end, Mr. Comptroller, that I know when my father passed away, we looked online and found that, in fact, there was a significant amount, maybe a few hundred dollars in various accounts left there. And you made it very simple. We did have to produce a death certificate and showing that we were the heirs. But this was money that really was his, and it belonged to the estate as he passed on. And I think people, one, many of my constituents, certainly in my Yonkers district and beyond, every dollar really matters. And so this opportunity to get money that rightfully belonged to someone in your family, thank you for making that a very easy process and for being here to make sure that all of our constituents know they can get these funds that belong to them. Thank you. Thank you, Tom. Senator. Thank you so much.
And, of course, our wonderful member of the State Assembly, Assemblymember David Buchwald.
Thank you. Thank you, Comptroller Napoli, and thank you to County Executive George Latimer for the invitation to join you this afternoon. This search that the county has done takes me back to my time when I was in local government in the city of White Plains. I was on the Common Council during the Great Recession, and we were going through a budget process, and I typed in White Plains into the State Comptroller website and passed that information on. The city put forward those claims. That's not how we balanced the city budget that year, but it helped great institutions like the White Plains Library and others who benefit from government here in White Plains. So my kudos first to the county executive and his team for making sure to leave no stone unturned in finding ways to provide the crucial services that Westchester County residents rely on. And then also tell a personal story, which is my mother found her old child book passbook savings account on the unclaimed funds site. So all those little equivalents of the piggy bank account that she'd been so proud of when she was a young girl, putting into the bank, getting a little statement back in her passbook account, you know, that all came back to her as an adult, thanks to the state comptroller's work and the work his office does. And I encourage really every New Yorker to search this database. Don't just search all the names and relatives and friends that the comptroller listed. Don't forget, use common misspellings of your name as well. If you spell Buchwald accidentally with a K, then, you know, if an organization does that, they send it to one of my relatives, you know, that, and then they report back to the comptroller's office. That's why it never reached us, because they should have spelled it with an H. So it's the sort of thing, like, you can have a field day, and if you make someone really happy, whether it's yourself, a family member, or a friend, then that's really a fantastic thing to do. And you have to remember, this is money that belongs to Westchester residents, and they deserve every opportunity to have it back, fueling our economy. So I'm really pleased that both County Executive Latimer and Comptroller DiNapoli are here highlighting this opportunity locally that people can take advantage of. And the Comptroller, his office, has done a fantastic job. He was pretty modest in saying how much of an advancement his office has put forward in the unclaimed funds program. But it used to be a much more involved claims process. Now it is so straightforward. And if you do rely on the phone calls to make your claim, they'll even tell you how long you have to wait on the phone. And there's no, if every company that you had to wait on hold for would tell you that in advance, it'd be a much better world. So that having been said, thank you again. Thank you all for being here and spreading the word.
Thank you, Assemblyman. Assemblyman makes a good point about there could be misspelling. So that's why I always say when you can't sleep at 2 in the morning and you're going on your computer, our website is a great place for you to hang out for a few hours because you can do all kinds of things with it. So we're going to do a presentation to the county exec. I'm joined by our Senator Assemblymember.
So first to Westchester County, this is going to go right in to balance the budget.
So as we have the County Executive Ken Jenkins.
Yes, Ken Jenkins is here. So there he is right there. So that's 20 million. 20,000, sorry, you wanted that extra zero. 20,208 dollars and 62 cents. Thank you very much.
We're going to run this straight over to the bank. Put it in the ATM. Change their mind. And here's the millions over here. I know one of our ones got millions on it, right?
And this is just a visual to make the point out about how much money is owed to Westchester County. So I did have a million on my mind for a reason. And $272,182,687. So this is how much the accounts for Westchester are valued at. So this is not far away fantasy stuff. This is real money that's owed to Westchester County residents. Again, thanks to County Executive Latimer, and Senator Mayor and Assemblymember Buchwald for helping us get the word out about our unclaimed funds program. Please, this is not a trick. It's not make-believe. Real money. We want to return it. And there are various ways that you may be connected to one of these accounts. Come down to the White Plains Library today if you can. And if you can't, search online or call that 800 number. Or certainly, you could call the Assemblyman's office, the Senator's office. They know how to contact us. We often get referrals from our state legislators, especially for folks that may have a more complicated claim, such as an inheritance situation. And our staff is very proactive. Our bias is to work very hard to return this money. We're not looking to keep it. So thank you for helping us get the word out about this program. And I hope everyone wants to take another one.
Can we hold for one more?
Thank you.
Thank you. Do press have any questions on the unclaimed funds program? If not, I know the county exec and I are available to say anything.
And I do want to recognize we have our Director of Consumer Protections, James Faisano, with us here. As always, our Director of Communications, Catherine Chaffee. And our Chief of Staff, Andrew Ferris. Any other questions at all for us as a group? If not, then if you want any one-on-one interviews, certainly with the controller, by all means.
Thank you, Ken. Thank you for inviting us and hosting us. Great to be here. Thanks, everybody.